conceived and played by Burlington. Was the shooting of a documentary on teenage stress. The project is being produced by the Greater Boston Cable Television in cooperation with Burlington High. Director Steve Kostant says the docudrama deals with peer pressure and how some teenagers cope with it. And one of the leads, Sara Smith, says there's a lot of reality in the script.
Yes, I think it's a very real role that could happen in any high school. I think it is.
What was your first impression when you started to read the script?
Well, we got to help write the script, and so it was all of our input in it, and so, you know, I think it's what really goes on.
Do you think the issue of peer pressure is taken too far now?
Yeah.
Do you think too much emphasis is placed on it?
I think it's really hard, and everybody pressures you to do things, but you don't have to fall into it if you don't want to, you know?
Well, you don't seem like a person that's going to fall into it.
I don't know.
Do you feel sometimes a little peer pressure?
I guess everybody does, occasionally.
What do you have to say? If you had to sum it up, what would you say to for anybody who does feel a lot of pressure?
Just try to be yourself and don't worry what anybody else thinks.
The number of teenage suicides are skyrocketing nationally. Psychologists are trying to help young people develop better skills to cope with their growing pains. One major point is to let teens know they are not alone. The Burlington High School play is one way to help young people. Two high school students, Sara Smith and Stephanie Kendrick, authored this play. Stephanie also plays a leading role. The high school junior says she's not at all like her character, but she can relate.
Not really. Well, in a way, but not as much as the role is. It's sort of over-exaggerated in the role.
But have you known a lot of Bobbies?
Yeah. I hang around up at B in the bathroom, you know, between classes and stuff, and just, I get along with people like that, so I can relate to it.
Are you worried about too much peer pressure?
Yeah.
Why?
It's around the school a lot, and there's a lot of pressure, you know, coming around from all sides, from parents, and mostly from kids, and teachers, and things like that.
Do you think what's being done here today is going to help alleviate it, maybe? Or at least teach some kids about it?
Hopefully. I think that'll come across. I don't know, but, you know, with suicide and stuff, there wasn't much really. They're not going into drugs or anything, or alcohol in this, you know, particular movie. But they have done another movie, I don't know, Under the Influence.
Have you known any friends that have been pushed almost suicide?
Pushed into suicide? No.
Do you think this is a good yardstick to teach them not to?
Maybe. You know, it depends, though, because, like, if she doesn't die at the end, people might think that, you know, well, they got away with it, you know, she didn't actually die and her parents actually cared for her more, and somebody might try it and then, you know, actually die, you know.
For 18-year-old Eric Roberts, Oliver, the docudrama gives him a chance to experience acting before the cameras. Eric says he'd like to pursue a career in drama after he graduates and feels his role as the antagonist represents quite a challenge and test to his acting ability.
I'd like to be able to go into communications as a career, and when I heard about the audition, I just jumped at the chance.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel it's a good measuring tool as to how well you might do in the future?
Both with acting and with actually the technical facet of television, yeah, I think so.
It's pretty quick-paced.
Yeah, and there's a lot of things to know and a lot of things to do.
What have you learned so far?
That it takes a lot to get one scene done. I mean, there's so many shots and so many angles and different things.
Do you know your role is that of a kind of a real person that you wouldn't trust too well.
Right.
Do you find that a challenge, and do you find that very common with some of the people that you've known?
It's hard for me because it's hard for me to draw on that type of character because I don't think that I'm like that. And but I do know people who are like that, so I can just think about them and draw on their personality.
Teenagers oftentimes feel pressure from their peers and their parents. Often it's difficult for the young people to open up and tell someone how they feel. Associate Principal of Burlington High, Keith Manville, says this is where the docudrama comes in. Manville hopes it will open some lines of communication. The associate principal says he doesn't believe the problems of teenage stress is widespread, but he thinks that this play will help the students.
I wouldn't say it's a common problem, no, but it is definitely a problem. And we do have kids reacting to things that they probably wouldn't do because of what their friends have suggested them to do and things of that nature, yeah.
What do you try to tell them when you bring them into your office? How do you try to handle this sort of situation?
I think there's two stages of it. You have to react to the incident, first of all, and then once that's done, we try and impress upon the kids the need to think for themselves, to make their own decisions, to not be pressured by what their friends have to say.
Teenagers grow up quick. Do you think they're more mature now than they were, say, 5 years ago?
No, I don't really think they're more mature than they were. I think a lot of them think they're more mature than people were 5 years ago, but I think they're just about the same.
Are they receptive, though?
Yes, definitely.
Holiday celebrations abound in the northern Middlesex area. Tonight you'll be viewing a docudrama written and conceived and played by Burlington. It deals with the pain and anxiety that goes in being a high school student and how certain people relate to it. Following the presentation, we'll be taking phone calls on tonight's subject matter.
What's the matter, Corey? Trouble in paradise?
What's the matter with you?
Me! Everything is my responsibility!
I still love him!
You still mine!
Something like this. What is the matter with you?
Why are you talking to her?
I'm not doing anything. I'm just innocent conversation, Pete.
Honest.
He's
just out of here, Harvey. Get out of here.
Just innocent conversation.
Move on. Get the hell out of here.
See you later, Harvey.
Harvey!
Why'd you have to do that?
Why'd I have to do that? I don't want him talking to you.
Why don't you want him talking to me? He's just my friend.
Who's your boyfriend, Corey? I am.
Possible points. That works out to be an 82 out of 100. Not too bad. Okay. Gail, would you pass out paper for everyone, please? And please take all of your books off of the desks. Since you all did your homework last night, I'm going to give you a little quiz. Skip, do you have a note for being late for class?
No.
No, then I'll see you tonight after school for 10. All right. Now, I'm going to put the questions on the board. Make sure you write them on your paper and the answers.
What's the name of that thing where something comes from nothing?
Spontaneous combustion.
Why? Is it on the test?
I don't know. I don't even want to take this test.
Did you guys do
get away out of this.
How?
Sockets doesn't work.
Put in the last one.
What's happening over here?
You see that?
What are you two doing? Who did this?
Nothing.
It was
Oh, funny. Both of you get out of here and go to Dr. Manville's
Why?
Office. Go.
Nobody did anything.
Okay, listen, I'm not discussing this. Just leave.
Take your test. At least we don't have to take it anymore. All
right. Okay, the rest of you settle down.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey.
Harvey, how you doing? Listen, I got a proposition for you. We're having a little problem Mike and I and a bunch of us with our computer homework. Wonder if you could help us out. Like the test tomorrow, with the test being tomorrow, you could fix the answers for us or something.
I can't do that, it's wrong.
Marilyn?
Who?
Dr. Marilyn?
Just a minute. See? And Dr. Manville, Corey and Bobby are here to see you. Can you see them now? Okay. Thank you.
But you get A's all the time, Harvey.
Just think of it, sharing the wealth.
Hey, those problems aren't that hard. You guys can do them.
No, we can't.
That's the point. We cannot do them. We need your help.
What's going to happen to us?
Suspension. Probably. Probably that's the worst thing that can happen to us.
Suspension?
Hey,
my parents will kill me.
Don't worry about it. It's no big deal.
Maybe not for you.
Don't worry about it. I'll get us out of this one.
Look, I just can't do it. Come on.
We'll take care of it all.
Look, I gotta get to class. Come on, Dad.
I don't believe they're doing that. I'm gonna get screwed in that class.
Man, I need those credits. I need those credits to graduate. We'll get them.
That's right. That's right.
We'll definitely get them.
We ain't messing around. We gotta show him.
Yeah.
Corey, Bobby, you wanna come in, please?
Nice.
Okay, Bobby and Corey, Mr. Barjack called, told me his side of the story. Why don't you tell me what happened in the classroom?
Well, okay, what would happen was, first of all, he told us we were going to have a test. And the papers were passed out, and I saw Corey filing it as a second he should not file. So I was filing my nails, you know, just not really paying attention to what I was doing. And it slipped and fell into the light, you know,
okay,
into the electric
Bobby,
socket.
Let me make sure I got this straight. You're telling me that you were filing your fingernails, and the nail file slipped inadvertently went into the light socket.
Now, how could it be so hard to believe? I mean, I wasn't paying attention to things.
And you don't put a nail file in an electrical socket.
No kidding,
by
you
accident.
Don't.
Your Mr. Barzak's interpretation of this is that you, in cahoots with your buddy over here, stuck the file into the socket to get thrown out of the class. Because neither one of you are ready for the test.
But I was all prepared for the test. So was Corey. I got my homework, and if he wants to see it, I'll show it to him.
I don't think he wants to see it. I don't think he wants to see either one of you for the rest of the year.
Why are we doing it?
Wait a second. What's your role in that? What are you doing down here anyway? 4 years I haven't seen you in this office.
I was sitting next to Bobby.
Yeah, and?
Just like she said.
Yeah, we really shouldn't bring her into this. She had nothing to do with it. I mean, she literally had really nothing to do with it. It was my accident. And it's her first time ever down here, I mean.
That's true. It's her first time ever down here. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to have to call both sets of parents. We'll probably send you home for the rest of the day. I'm probably going to have both sets of parents in tomorrow. And we'll talk about restitution for the damage done in the room.
Why can't we just have suspension?
Barzak did overreact.
Totally, completely.
I don't think Mr. Barzak overreacted. I think maybe you guys overreacted to the threat of the test.
Well, my father's out of town, so suspension sounds fine to me. But yeah, I don't think Corey should take the rap for this.
Well, all right, here's what we'll do. I'm going to contact your parents. I'll contact your parent. I'll have them in tomorrow. We'll talk about it. And I'll decide on the suspension at that time. Okay, why don't you guys go back to class now?
Thanks, I'll go to you.
So you going to fifth period today or what?
What's the matter, Harvey? There's something in my locker.
What Harvey? What are you doing? What the hell?
It's going to get a lot worse if you don't do what we asked.
Look, Pete, I'll do what you say. Just please, no more of that.
Then in the first place, Harvey, this would never happen.
Too bad, Harvey.
Hey, you shouldn't keep flammable stuff like books in there.
I needed that book. Come on, you guys. What are you doing?
All you need is your computer stuff.
Look,
I'll find you later on.
Okay, I'll just do what you tell me. Just, please, leave me alone.
All right, go.
Hey,
see you
later,
Bobby.
Watch out.
God.
Wall boy.
Gotta get him back for this, Harvey. You need revenge.
How can I get him back? If I try anything, they'll get me again.
Well, do you want him to continue pushing you around like this?
No. Nope.
Gotta fight back. Show him you can't be pushed around.
Well.
Come on, Harvey. I'll take care of everything.
I suppose so.
All right. Let's clean this up.
Actually, peer group pressure and peer group identification are pretty much related. Peer group identification and pressure simply mean that a person wants to increase his or her feelings with a group, and as a result, they kind of adopt the kinds of things that they're doing.
For example, if it's a group at a party and everybody's drinking, you might want to drink, even though you don't drink, to feel part of a group.
We want so bad to be accepted and to become part of a group that will actually do everything the group is doing, so we're accepted and feel more
please.
Secure in ourselves.
Whoever has stolen the master key to all classrooms,
I wonder who did that. Talk about a feeling of security, having a master key.
Oh, wait a minute, one second. I think the discussions we had here today are fantastic, and to end it now, I don't think it's right.
My grandpa.
Why don't we plan to pick up this a little bit at our next meeting?
Would you like it?
How's that, okay? All right, I'll see you tomorrow then. Have a good day.
She'd be home with supper at 7 o'clock, and it's 2 minutes off. Would you set the table, please? We're going out tonight, and it's going to be a rush.
Sure.
Thank you.
Why are you so busy?
Well, I got to finish this report, and we're going out to meet the boss tonight for my promotion, and I hope I get it. How are you doing?
Okay. I have some things to tell your mom tonight at supper.
Well, why don't you wait till she gets home, and then you can tell both of us, okay?
Day.
Yeah, we gotta eat fast, you know, we're going out.
I know, we have appointments for drinks with the boss. I know all about it.
All right.
Let me put this Chinese food out on the table. And we'll be ready in just a sec. Oh, it was a day and a half, let me tell you, today. We worked on that contract. Tomorrow, if we sign the contract, it's really gonna be fantastic. It's up from there.
For me.
Well, since you guys are in such a good mood, I'll tell you what happened today at school. Okay, we were in chemistry class, and there was this girl next to me, and she stuck my fingernail file in the socket on the side of the table.
Ugh, what'd she do that for?
To get out of the surprise quiz, and the teacher thought it was both of us, because we both went flying back, and so we both got sent down to the office.
Was it both of you?
Me. It was her.
It was her?
Corey, I don't believe this. This is absolutely ridiculous. You know better. You know right from wrong. Oh, I didn't do it. She did. Corey, don't tell me you had absolutely nothing to do with it. Well, I just told her which socket that worked. Are you telling me you got in trouble today because you didn't do something? Is that the way it happened?
Corey, I'm surprised.
Did you have to go down to see Dr. Manville? I had enough with Dr. Manville with your sister Susan.
That must be
Corey, gone. I don't believe this. You're making too light of this.
Hello?
Well, I don't know.
Oh, hello, Dr. Manville.
Oh, no, I don't believe it. Corey.
Yes.
How serious is this?
Yes, we were just discussing it, yes.
I know, Corey. You told me it wasn't your fault. You already told me that, but what really happened?
Right, well, she said that she had a little problems.
I guess so. Dr. Manville doesn't call people into his office
and call
their parents for nothing.
Well, yes, I suppose we could. Tomorrow afternoon. Yeah. Well, someone will be there. Thank you.
I have my appointment tomorrow. I can't make any meeting tomorrow. I have that contract to sign.
Well, I can't go either. I'm going to be out of town.
Phil, I can't believe it. I've been talking about these contracts and how important they are to me all this time.
But was it tomorrow?
Of course it's tomorrow. Tomorrow's the only day I can do it. Corey, I could kill you for this. How did you get yourself involved in a thing like this? What is the matter with you? I'm going to have to call him tomorrow, as usual, and break an appointment that you made. Wonderful. My responsibility again. I can't believe this. I'm losing my appetite. Corey, I could kill you for this. That you got involved in something. Dr. Manville happens to be very important in this town. I'm involved with him on different city occasions. This is really terrific. You really make me feel good.
It's not you. It's me. So don't...
No, it involves us.
But what you do is a direct reflection on us.
Everything that you do involves us.
That's not fair. Oh, brother. Oh, I can't believe this. My appetite is just gone. I hope the rest of this day turns out better than it has been so far.
Yes, Bob.
Oh,
boy. Yeah, we'll be right there. You're right at the restaurant now? Okay, yeah, we're on our way. Sure, no problem. Yeah, bye-bye. Look, they're already at the restaurant. We gotta go.
Good idea. I could use a good drink about
later. Corey, get your story straight for tomorrow.
Come on, Phil.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Is Pete there? Hi. You wanna come over tonight? Yeah, my parents just went out. Okay. See you then. Bye.
Right, the Manvilles.
Yeah. Well, he called my house during supper tonight, and, it really wasn't that big a thing, what happened to me and Bobby. She just stuck a nail file in there, and then my parents blew it out of proportion.
What else is there?
Yeah. Trying to talk, and you're trying to change the subject.
What's wrong with that? I don't understand. It's too confusing lately. No, don't do that guilt stuff.
Tell your young gentleman friend to leave, would you please?
I don't believe this.
Believe it, Corey. Show your gentleman friend out.
I don't believe this. I don't believe this, Phil. Here we go again. I can't believe this. What is happening to her, Phil? Phil, what is
happening? Corey, get in here.
Corey! What is going on with you? You're going crazy in school. You're doing all the wrong things. You're breaking the rules here. You're having people over when they're not supposed to be.
We weren't doing anything wrong.
What is the matter with you? You're behaving just like your sister Susan.
All over again!
Don't go pulling the line on about Susan on me, because I'm not like Susan.
Corey!
This behavior is exactly like Susan's!
Corey, we have rules in this house. No boys while your mother and father are out!
We weren't doing anything wrong!
The thing is, that you broke the rule, that was what was wrong. Never mind what was going on here. I don't care what you think you're doing, but right now the rules in this house are ours.
It won't happen again.
Go to your room. We're going to talk to you later, young lady.
So what is going on here? I don't believe this. I can't deal with this any longer. You're going to have to spend more time with her.
Me?
Yes, you!
I am the full provider of this family. Yours is the part-time job. You are going to have to slow down.
Always
for
8 me. It's always my responsibility. What about your dear responsibility? She's your daughter, too. I spent 12 years in this house with those kids. Don't I have any right to be kind to myself?
Yeah.
Everything is mine.
Who's going to tell you things?
I realize that I'm so great.
Can't go on thinking nothing's wrong. What now? Who's gonna drive you home tonight?
All right, just go upstairs. We'll talk about this later. Go upstairs, please.
I can't believe this.
He loves
everything...
me more than you do.
Did you hear her, Phil? He loves her more than we do.
She's not going to see him again.
You bet you're not going to see him again. I don't believe this, Phil.
You know what the trouble with us is? We're too busy.
Who's going to plug their ears when you... Who's gonna drive you home tonight?
Can you give me the suicide prevention number?
Dr. Mandel's office, please. Dr. Mandel, hi. This is Mrs. Sanger calling. Corey's mother? Yes, I know. You spoke with my husband last night. Listen, I feel really bad about this, but I have a previous commitment today, and I really cannot make that meeting. Yes, I know. I'm really surprised that Corey was even involved in anything like that, but... she's a really bright girl. I have a feeling that if you spoke with her, it would all be taken care of. You would? I would appreciate that. Really, I would. I will be in touch with you. Thank you again. Bye-bye. Sit down and eat your breakfast. I just spoke with Dr. Mandel. I had to cancel the appointment. I do have that commitment this afternoon that I have to go to. He said that he'll speak with you himself.
Just a cup of coffee this morning, Elmer. I'm late again.
It's on the table, Phil.
Okay, good.
Oh, I have to get out on time today, please. Let's get moving here.
You know, young lady, you and your mother...
please, don't start with that now. I'm in a hurry. I want to get going. I don't want this on my mind
today.
All right. I've got too much on my mind already. I must sign this contract. It must go through, all right? We'll continue this at another time.
All right. Young lady, just remember, today, no surprises, please.
Come on, Phil. I have to get going.
I know. Just relax.
Relax. I'm in a hurry. This is really a big deal, you know? Corey, don't forget to do the dishes, please, in the sink. How are you getting to school?
Julie's giving me a ride.
Come on, Phil, let's get going, please.
And have a good day.
What does it look like?
I'll tell you, I couldn't believe what they did last
night.
How was what?
I, you having trouble with Pete, huh, Corey?
Why don't you mind your own business? What's going on? What'd you tell your friends?
Nothing. It was important to me. I just told them what happened.
Obviously can't talk to you or your parents.
Talk to her?
Oh, what's the matter with me?
You know what's wrong with you. Can we just talk?
Not now, later. I gotta go to class.
Come on,
Wilson. Hey, what's wrong with your parents?
Leave her alone.
You're a jerk, Wilson. You know that, and you.
Life's becoming a big soap opera, huh, Pete?
So what is it?
Well, for starters, why'd you have to tell all your friends that the wall would happen between us?
All right, I guess that was kind of dumb. But that's not all of it. I know that's not all of it. What is your problem lately, anyway? You're depressed all the time. Like the time we went out this past weekend. We were all out having a good time. Then we had to come home because you were in a bad mood. What's the deal? Apparently you can't talk to me or anything.
You know why I can't talk to you, don't you?
No, I don't.
Because you're too wrapped up in yourself, and all you think about is yourself, how to make you look good.
Wrapped up in myself?
Yes. How to make you look good. You don't care about anybody else. What about Harvey? Don't you think it's pretty low what you're doing to him?
As for myself, that's what I want to do.
That's low.
I don't believe you. I pay you all kinds of attention.
The wrong kind of attention in my eyes.
I think if we love each other, that's important.
Oh, you love me, do you? How can I even tell you love me?
I don't believe you're saying this.
You don't believe I'm saying
it. You're just like your parents.
I'm not like my parents. You don't even have to bring them into this.
I do have to bring them into this because that's important. That's part of the whole thing. It's like the final straw.
My parents have nothing to do with it.
They have everything to do with it. We can't get around them.
You know what I think? I think that you want to go be with Lara. That's what I think. Standing next to her, just looking at her and everything. Are you done with me? Gonna go on and try to be with somebody else now? Don't get what you want, you go somewhere else. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. That's part of your problem.
It's my problem.
It is, and I think we ought to end it. And I have to go to class anyway.
Go to class.
That's none of your damn business.
Where is he?
Right there. There's a little fireman.
Oh,
All right, what is it you want, Harvey?
Okay, I know basically what you want me to do. I just need some specific information, like, what's your last name?
You know my last name is Wilson.
Okay, I got a Pete Wilson, and what about other people that you
want? Don't worry about that. I'll give you a list later on of all the names. In fact, I'll see you about 7:45 tonight. Okay. Up in the computer room.
The thing is, what if the door's locked? How am I going to be able to get in?
The door won't be locked. I have the master key.
You have the master key?
Shh!
You have the master key?
I have my ways, Harvey. Don't worry about it. I'll go up there, open the door for you, let you in. You're not taking the key from me.
Okay.
You do the work. Do my work first.
Okay.
If you have time, do the other people on the list. Then I'll come back and check to see what you did.
Okay, I'll do it.
Okay, you better not mess up.
I don't want any more Lauka scenes.
It'll be a lot worse.
A lot worse. Okay. I'll just do it now. I have some studying to do.
Okay, why don't you study, Harvey?
Yeah.
Have fun. Come on, let's go. Let's split. I don't like this place. You got it?
Right here.
All right. We have them now.
All set for the test today, Chloe?
You ready?
Hey guys, we got nothing to worry about.
Do you want a little help on it?
Thanks, anyway.
Okay.
I guess we're all set for the test.
No doubt about it.
Studying for 3 hours last night.
It's gonna be such a breeze.
What are you doing tonight, Ron?
Me? Nothing.
Well, a bunch of us, we're going out. Probably a basketball game. You wanna come along?
Yeah, sure. I'll go.
Good. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to load in test number 4. Type in load test 4, please. Game's off, please.
Oh, sorry.
Load test 4. Begin. Good luck.
Don't worry about it.
Michael.
What were you this morning?
Oh, I'm sorry, God.
What's the matter with you?
Pete and I just woke up.
Well, how long have you been going out with Pete?
About 3 months.
About 3 months? Well, that's kind of tough when you break up with your boyfriend. Had any other problems in school? I'm a little concerned, you know. You were in my office yesterday the first time in 4 years. Now I got you sitting out here in tears. What about cheering? What happened down at cheering?
I don't know exactly. I just left.
No reason?
I don't know.
Just couldn't take it down there anymore? Corey, what's going on? You got problems at home or something?
No.
You sure? You want to talk about anything? No? Well, listen, Corey, it's late. You have a ride home? You need a ride home?
I've got a ride home.
You all set to get home? All right. I'm going back inside. I'll be in my office for another 20 minutes. You want to come in and talk, that's fine. Otherwise, I'll see you tomorrow, okay? All right. Take care of yourself.
All you gotta do is change tests.
Okay.
So my work is first. Then if you have time, get to the rest of the people.
Okay, I'll just do what you want. I don't want to have any more locker scenes.
All right, you better not mess up, because it'll be a lot worse.
I won't mess up. Look, I know what I'm doing. I won't mess up.
All right, then I'll be back to check.
Okay.
Thank you.
Corey, where is she?
I don't know. I don't really care either.
All right.
Yeah! 10. 9. 6. 5.
Specific information, like, what's your last name?
My last name is Wilson. Okay, I got a Pete Wilson name. What about other people that don't worry about that? I'll give you a list later on. You know what I mean? In fact, I see you in a corner gate tonight. I'm in a computer room. Don't let people. I have the master key. The master key.
Sounds like you're overwhelmed or feeling like, you know, all these things are hitting you at one time. Yeah.
Yeah, my family, the major part of it, they don't even understand, they don't even care. Yeah.
At school and at home, and you say you don't want to really go on. Are you telling me you're thinking of killing yourself?
Yeah, I just don't see any reason to go on anymore. Yeah, I guess I do want to kill myself.
Okay. Have you thought about how you might do that, Corey? Okay, so you have pills?
Mm-hmm.
Have you taken any?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, well, I'd like you not to fall asleep, so that's why I want to keep you on the phone and talk to you. Is anyone else around?
My parents are home. My dad is, but they don't know what's going on.
Corey, are you willing to go to a hospital?
Yeah, I guess.
Have you taken any more pills? A couple more.
Corey, get off the phone, will you, please? I got a business call to make. Corey!
I'm trying to get you, Alan. Where have you been? Look. Look, never mind. Look. Yeah, Corey's in the hospital. Yes, yes. All right. Yes, the hospital. All right. I'll explain to you when you get here, okay? Just come on down. All right. Yeah. Yeah, bye.
Thank you.
Mrs. Sanger?
Are you the doctor?
Yes. No, I'm not the doctor. I'm a psychiatric social worker.
Can I see you outside here for a minute?
Is it all right to leave her?
Yeah,
she'll be all right?
She really needs to rest right now. Okay, I'd like to speak with you in private if we could. She will be okay.
We'll be back for you. How did this happen?
Look,
I can't believe
there's no
it.
Reason in the oh, world why this should happen okay. in our house. We
okay,
there's
I need
no
to have,
warning.
I need to have you calm down for a minute. You're getting hysterical. It's not going to help the situation. I don't know what the reasons are exactly for why this happened. There are probably many reasons why this happened to your daughter. But she needs your support right now, and she needs your help. And the best thing you can do right now is, I think tonight, to go home and to relax, to rest. I can call you in the morning. We will keep her overnight in the hospital. That's my recommendation, okay? Your situation is not a unique situation. I realize she's your daughter, and that you care and you're concerned about her right now. But the best you can do right now is stay relaxed.
Nothing's wrong. Who's gonna drive you home tonight? Who's gonna hold it down?
pretend not to.
Hey, Queen Boba. Nam Ke Chao.
Motor dead. We fix. 1 hour.
TC, maybe you can help them. Yeah. I knew I was here for some reason.
Now you can enjoy fruit.
A bowl of peaches.
The same way they do in France. Called sorbet.
A bowl of pineapple.
It's not a sherbet nor an ice cream.
A bowl of pineapple.
But a smooth blend of real fruit and pure juice. All natural. So it's a delicious way.
Strawberries.
To enjoy the real taste.
Strawberries.
Of fresh fruit. Introducing Dole Fruit Sorbet. The idea is very French.
Oui.
But the taste is all Dole.
How can you tell if a woman has finesse? Just look at her hair.